Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and welcome if you are new around here or you clicked on this video and you're probably wondering who I am. My name is Mia and I am a very sportive and active person. I'm a gymnast. I was on the Special Olympics team. I still am. Back in 2018, I was the runner-up in the Summer Games. And 3 years ago, in 2019, I became the gymnast champion of the whole thing. And it really felt good that I was a champion. I'm not trying to brag or anyone out there. It's just something I feel really good about myself. And hit the red subscribe button right below me. Or click my profile picture and hit the red button, subscribe. And once you subscribe, there is a little gray bell and you click it and you see three different options like personal, mention all, that kind of thing. Hit the top one, which is all. That will notify you that all my videos you'll be notified for and you'll be the first one to watch, and I love for you to subscribe. If you are a returning subscriber, make sure to hit the notification bell. Make sure it's all the way on because you are subscribed and you want to make sure that you're notified for all my videos so that you guys can comment below and like it and watch my videos because I know 100% of you guys love to watch my videos. So a while back, I did an update with you guys, and this is not much of an update. This is something that I want to make. It's more of like, let's have a conversation together. That's what this video is about. So I'm just gonna sit down, and I went shopping with my mom. So that's, I'm gonna show you what I got, and talk about other things that are serious to talk about. And hopefully this might encourage you guys to keep watching, and I might do another one next year maybe. We just have to see when it's gonna happen, but we're gonna do it. Because usually when I do my updates, they're usually in separate videos, but this time I'm doing one full clip rather than doing many different ones and having to edit it all. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing I have to talk about, it's kind of like an update that I'm talking about. It's the death situation that's going through. You guys are the best supporters out there, and I know like 6 months ago I would like have my camera out and record it and then just spoke about how I felt really deep inside. Because lots of people, when they go through a death grieving process like I went through, they feel like, okay, and then they just move on from that point. But mine was a bit different because I handle my emotions differently. And every person out there is different in the way they feel. And when that sort of started, I did the right thing. I told everyone I knew, like, I felt safe talking to older people, like adults, mainly because they're more safer to talk to. But if I talk to somebody my age or younger, it can make me feel a bit uncomfortable because they don't really go through that process, and adults do. I'm not sure just me, but it was just my comfort zone and the way I sort of felt. So I just can't thank you guys enough that I was able to speak to you like how I felt inside when I used to write all those emotions, type those emotions out. But now, since I've felt those emotions, they're all negative emotions that I was feeling. And I didn't want to be on the negative side of things, because if I thought on the negative side, then when I grow older, more negativity would come my way, and it's not going to stop. And keeping me down and holding me back from my fears and worries and all these emotions that aren't true. So 6 months later in the grieving process, I'm not in the process anymore, but I've made the choice to move on. It was a really tough choice to make, because Parker was someone who was really cared for, and we knew how moving and touching he was, and we just had this incredible experience and ride with him when he was alive. And it was hard to process that he was dead, and I started feeling those emotions. But when I moved on, it kind of felt good. It felt good. That made me feel good, and really made me proud inside, because I can feel the little grin inside of me that wants to move on, that I want to move on. And I want to think on the positive side, because I want to think about all the positive emotions. And I've been feeling, the emotions I'm feeling right now is different feelings, but I'm trying my best to find other emotions that I can feel and that make me happy. And I'm pretty proud that I moved on. And if someone out there knows me on my channel, might comment in this video like, "Oh my god, I can't believe he moved on. I'm so proud." Because when I mentioned it to other people, like my best friend Avery, when I mentioned it to her, she's like, "I'm so proud of you." And I'm just like, "Thanks." And I don't understand why I said that. But that was just the way I just sort of felt inside. And being on the negative side is not the best approach to think about death. But the better approach is to think it in more of a positive way, so that I don't feel self-guilt and self-consciousness. Self-conscious. That's the best word to say. And trying to hold it in, and the negative emotions were not true to feel that way, but we knew how caring Parker was when he was around. So I've been doing better with the process. I'm not thinking about it as much, but there are times that I like to talk about him, but sometimes my friends can reject it. But when I talk to my boyfriend about it, he loves to hear me about it. Okay, so I kind of want to show you guys what I got. So I went to Title 9 up in Green Lake, and I got some new clothes, because we are going to Chelan Thursday through Sunday next weekend. And we're going to Hawaii for my birthday. My dad is doing a race up there. It's the world championship. He qualified. He got the final spot. I'm pretty proud of him. So the first thing I got was this flowy dress. One sec. This is what I got. I think it's really cute. It's this like blue. This blue color with all these really pretty different colored flowers on it. And I think it's really cute that for me to wear. And it's going to be, it's more like a really silk, breezy fabric, because I want the breeze and to feel cool, especially in really hot heat, because it'll be 100 degrees in Chelan. I also got, that's the receipt. I don't need to show you the receipt. because it's kind of like personal information on it. I also got this shirt. It's very like a silk feel. It has this cute little pocket. It's just this tie-dye blue and white together, and I think it's really nice that I can like wear this with a pair of shorts. And I got a pair of shorts. So I got this green short. This is a short, and I think it's really nice and cool, and I can wear. Those are pretty much the things I got from Title IX, and comfortable enough to wear in Hawaii and Chelan, because it'd be really hot. But the dress I showed you guys, I'm wearing that tonight because we're going out to dinner. We're out to get drinks and that kind of thing. So those are the things I got from Title IX, and I'm glad I got those. Okay, let's talk about Best Buddies. Where do I start with Best Buddies? So, 1 year ago, I was the champion, and now I'm the co-champion, which is very exciting, and I couldn't believe I was a champion. I didn't know, because I raised over $15,000. It's a lot of money, but I was able to, and I was glad I was a champion. I'm not trying to brag at all, and I didn't do much this year for Best Buddies, because I put so much effort into it, and yeah. So tomorrow I am going to Ravenna Brewery, which is up in Ravenna, and there would be food. I was told there would be food, drinks, and ice cream, which is exciting. Everyone loves ice cream, and it's hot out there. And tomorrow's the kickoff for the champion of the year or the gala. Well, the gala is more like a party, and that's where they will announce the runner up and the champion. So there's runner up and a champion. It's tough to raise a lot of money, but I'm pretty proud of it, and yeah, so tomorrow I'll be in Ravenna Brewery, and I will be speaking, because the people who are talking, these are the people who were the champions from the last 2 years. So there was a champion from 2020, and I was 2021, and yeah, I think it's and the mission director of Best Buddies made a speech for us, and she said that she'll make the edits and print it out and speak, because I'm not a keynote. I'm more of like a public speaker, and I'm given the opportunity to do it, and I'm proud that I'm speaking in front of a group, because in front of a large groups of people, and everyone loves to hear me speak, and they always tell me that they're always proud of me, and it kind of feels good inside that I'm one of the few that can do it, because not a lot of people can bring that voice up like I can. I'm not trying to be offensive, but they just have trouble speaking up, but I'm just glad I got that voice and speak for myself, and to help other people in need that need it, and the voice is really important to be heard for lots of people, and it makes me feel good inside that I can speak for them. Okay, that was Best Buddies. Music. So up to my music, where I start. So yesterday I was hanging out with my boyfriend and we were doing music because he is my keyboardist, and you know, Paul. And we would he was keyboardist, I was on guitar, and we are playing an album. I'm not gonna say anything about it. It's gonna be a secret. But it'll be released next year on the 22nd on his birthday of January. And yeah, we're excited. So two songs this month, two songs next month, and then blah, 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 blah. And once we're done, we can release it. And I'm so excited to release it because I originally had album 32, but 32 released on his birthday, but it's not gonna happen, and I can't, it doesn't give me enough time to record all the songs before his birthday and making that to a present for him. But yeah, I just didn't want to feel pressured, so that's been put off, but there will be an album next year, which I'm excited about, and yeah, I'm just grateful to given this opportunity to expand my music career, because when I was very first born, I was just listening to music, and then when I kept growing up, I would just sit in the back of the car just singing to the radio. And then started playing piano lessons at age of 6 and kept going with it. And then I was so bored in lockdown COVID and I wanted to do something involving music. And I did. And I'm so proud that I did. But there were band name changes. But it was fine. But I think Mia Esther Solo Band is the perfect name for the band. And I got more serious working on this because because 6 months ago I was going through a tough process, and that's how I got really serious in it, because I would like write a song about him and what other people would tell me, because I know that Kelvin told me that I need to keep the good memories I have with Parker, and I have lots of good memories with him, which is hard to name one, but me and Parker had more moving and touching moments, and I remember him swinging on the swings. I remember him pushing me on the swings, and that was the most memorable memory that I ever had with him. And that's never going to change. And no matter where Parker is, he'll still be in here. And I just want to remember him for the rest of his life and not feeling the negative emotions and feeling that guilt. But so far, I'm making really good progress on my music, and I'm really proud that I'm making really good progress on it, even though not releasing an album on his birthday, I am going to release it next year. I guess that's pretty much it I want to talk about with you guys, just music and Best Buddies and death a little bit. And yeah, so thank you very much for watching this video. Hopefully this wasn't too emotional for you. You can check my videos beside me and watch those, and the videos in the playlist, and yeah, you guys are the best people out there alive, and I cannot thank you guys enough for the support. And just please subscribe to my channel, because I love to hit my goal, which is 1,000,000K, But that's gonna take a while to get to that point. But I know we can do it. We're so close to 60, but we're falling off the wagon a little bit. I'm not desperate. But yeah. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye, guys.